Hello, everyone. Here playing Mora Barbara. To explain a bit, here are the rules. It's played on a 24 circle cell board placed on three concentric squares. Circles are connected with lines as shown as the following picture. So the goals, cows are stones. So in a mill is a row of three cows. So the goal is, of the game is to shoot 10 opponents' cows or to block the opponents so they have no legal moves. If you get three cows in a row, which is a mill, you get the option to capture one of your opponent's stones, cows. But it cannot be a cow or stone that's in a row of three currently. So there's two phases. During the first phase, you place a single cow per turn on an empty circle. So we'll just both be filling up the board. If by placing a cow forms a new mill or several mills of his color, then he gets to the right to shoot one of his opponent's cows. The bear can also skip shooting and pass the turn if his opponent's if he wants. I don't know why that'd be the case, but interesting. Maybe for some, like, trapping or something. After all 12 cows have been placed on the board, the second phase begins. During this phase, you can move any cow to any empty adjacent circle along the drawn lines. Same with the first phase. If you get the right to shoot a cow if you make a line of three. Players are not allowed to break their own mills and remake them repeatedly by moving their cows back and forth. Each time a mill is formed, the player is allowed to shoot another of his opponent's cows. Keep in mind that breaking your own mills exposes the cows, which are in the mill, risking them being shot. So I guess I don't know if this is... It says, in generally accepted rules published by Mind Sports South Africa, a mill which is broken to form a new mill can't be formed again on next move. I don't know if... that's generally accepted rules, or if that's IG game rules. And when you only have three cows remaining, they turn into flying cows. They're allowed to go to any empty circle, not just adjacent ones. So that's because it started off playing with Megatown Matt. He was the one you saw recording our last Mora Barbara video. I'm streaming it today.
Yeah. What's up, folks? Playing some more Barbar. Personally, I don't know about you, Megatown Travis, but my favorite part about Mora Barbar is getting to getting to pretend to be a cow farmer.
There's some game in Board Game Arena, I know, that, like, we're vegetable farmers. And, like, I'm pretty sure we work together to, like, maximize our vegetable production or something like that.
Oh, that sounds cool. Veggie yeah, like games that are generally,
So if he makes this line of three right here, he would have the option to shoot one of my cows, which I generally don't want. It's called Veggie Garden. In Veggie Garden, each player cultivates their vegetables to help the community garden prosper. A game plays out over six rounds where each player takes turn manipulating the community garden to make it flourish. At the end of the game, each vegetable in the garden has a point value. Vegetables in the compost are worth zero. Whoever has the most points wins. Oh, so that's...
Oh, okay. So pretty interesting. And I'm sure you probably mentioned this, Travis. But just for the sake of... Get out of here. just for the sake of saying it again, there is the possibility that you can, that so Travis could win if every single move that we made was...
I'm just responding. So I don't know if that's a great opening for me, because I'm just responding and...
Right. But Travis could essentially win every single... Travis could win if...
So, well, you just got three. Made
essentially resulted in a draw. So if we filled up the whole entire board with our cows,
you just
it's
got,
like all of a sudden, boom.
You just got three, so you have a... Yeah.
All right, so this game won't result in a... in a... this game won't necessarily result in...
Oh, God.
Yeah, so you guys are going to watch out for that.
I was like,
Travis put his stone back in the same place. He could have put it on a one, though, and removed one of my stones. It's a tricky, though. We haven't played more Barba in a while. In fact, I think this might have been the very first game that we kicked off Board Game Wednesdays with. We both have a little extra time.
Maybe not. I can check what number board game it is, but I don't think it was one of the first.
Oh. Now, this is a tricky position. I'm basically...
Yeah, I gotta... You have to pick either one.
Bucked either way. But let's see what we can do. Tricky.
Is Board Games episode 13?
Wow. Wild.
So I think, let me check what the ones before that. Oh, nice. I was thinking about taking that middle one. Ouch.
Yeah, that's about what I expected to happen. What's tricky about this now, right, is Travis is still set. Basically, with the last move, it was preventing death by 1,000 cuts. We're kind of still in the same exact place we were beforehand, unfortunately.
We did a Rima. Okay, I was just naming some off. I don't know if we did back. It looks like the first one you did is backgammon.
Oh, nice. Good on.
And then a Rima. Backgammon, Arima, and then Mara Barba, looks like. Once that we did. Alright.
Tricky. However,
okay, so we each have one stone left. So after we place these down, we'll have to move them.
So ideally, I would have put that somewhere else. Unfortunately, I had to
the first phase of the game is complete.
Yes. And now this next phase gets tricky for obvious reasons.
I just blocked it.
Yeah, it's always tricky. I generally enjoy more Barba.
Yeah, that's right. Oh man, yeah, you definitely have this game. I didn't see that.
Woo!
I don't even know if there's a way to stop.
Yes, now the one, what I will say is that remember that when we, as we work through the game, it does sometimes wind up that the person who ends up with the least amount of stones at the end ends up winning because then you can move them anywhere on the board. Now, lucky for you, Travis, is you have C3 through C5 locked into place. I'm not allowed to remove those stones from the board.
Yeah, but they can't move back and forth like yours can to just get...
That's true, yes.
Get captured. So, I've lost two now, I think. So this game's looking a little rough for me. Your strategic capture was really good. First two strategic captures. Because I had you pretty much trapped, I thought. But then now just you can move back and forth. So.
Yeah. It is definitely a plus just being able to basically open that up.
Yeah, I can't even. There's nowhere I can even make three that I know of as well. And you can just. Even if I do, I think you could just capture and eliminate any of my attempts.
Yeah, at the same time, I would also consider this like one of the limitations of Mora Barba. The fact that all it takes is one person to get into a position like that, and then all of a sudden, you're basically set, you know?
I might just resign. I don't know. I mean, I guess I could go down to the three phase, but... But I would have to make a row of three to even do anything. So it helps with evading capture, but it doesn't help with winning, I would say. Unless you're both at three.
Yeah, definitely. Tricky, tricky, tricky.
I'm gonna go and resign that game. So no. Good game though. Definitely got me in a position that I did not want to be in.
It's a good game though. I like more Barbar. There's obviously the one limitation of the three stones. If you get them in the proper position, just being able to be like, ha ha.
But I mean, there are also, they're usually pretty quick games. So if you just get in those positions, then you start a new game.
Yeah, that's true. Oh, he's gonna get me, folks. Nothing I can do. That little, like, obtuse triangle you're able to make with E3, F2, and D3 is crucial. Every time. Every time. Crucial. Unsurprising. So now I just have to make sure that I'm able to essentially keep Travis from doing what I was able to do last time. Also, generally speaking, as long as whoever you're playing with, either one of you, as long as either one of you are able to remove one of the stones on the board, it automatically gets rid of the possibility for a stalemate. Yes, yes. We in business, folks. Maybe not like so particularly that was all, good business, but
that was all the stones placed.
That is all the stones placed.
Oh man. No. I'm still not. Hey, I'm not threatening three anywhere.
Yeah.
Are you kidding me, folks?
I don't know how I managed to do it. There may still be a possibility.
Really, just one capture. If I could have just done one capture.
Yeah.
It frees up a lot more room.
Oh, dang! I ain't paid no attention, apparently. Yo, it's good, though. We got multiple possibilities here.
Yeah.
For the most part.
Probably not the best, but at least I got a capture.
That is true.
Oh.
good move.
Oh man, that is a great move. I'm not really sure what to do.
Yeah, it gets tough. Get really lucky with
Oh no. Ugh. Alright. So I need to practice this game.
Yeah.
Which one did you take?
I took E5. Oh, okay.
Yep. I think I lost this game as well.
Oh my fucking god. Yeah. Well, I done goofed, folks.
And you're still threatening too.
That's true, that's true. Right. Yeah, that gets tricky, darn it.
Come back. Hopefully. I still think you have this one.
Yeah, probably. I basically just need to just pay attention and be careful. And
Oh, it's part of the three. Okay. So I can only capture that one. Yeah, see, I can't stop that. Ah.
I'm unstoppable. Here's where it starts to get real tricky, though, you know? Here's where it starts to get tricky, though. This can be a close one.
Nice. So I won't be able to win if I have less than three, right?
Correct. In theory. I don't know how many times we haven't just resigned. But also, if I'm not mistaken, also having three technically allows you... Obviously, in this case...
Yeah, I can jump wherever I... Oh, I could have jumped wherever I wanted. Yeah, I should have blocked that.
Yeah, is there any way for us to go back? Do you want to go back?
Yeah, sure.
Okay. How do we...
one sec. I
can... Do I have to finish my move and then go back?
No, I can...
All
right. I can let you do it. You might have to click something in the chat.
I think I need to finish this first. Here, let's do this. Let me do that. And now, why won't it let me click? Do I have to? Weird.
Nice. Good games, though.
Yeah, definitely.
I have to keep playing this one because I definitely want to figure this one out.
Absolutely.
Thanks for anyone to watch. This has been more Barbara.
More Barbara.
Thanks for watching, everyone. Goodbye.